Good morning, all of you. Now we are revising the chapter, the French Revolution. Now today we'll discuss about the outbreak of the revolution, but before that we'll discuss the role of philosophers in the French Revolution. John Locke, Rousseau, and that is now in 17th and 18th century, various philosophers give their ideas for the enlightenment of the society. Now first, like John Locke, he has written the book Two Treatises of Government. And according to this, he refutes the doctrine of divine and the absolute right of the monarch. Another philosophers like Rousseau, he proposed a form of government which was based on a social contract between people and their representatives. And the same, another philosopher, Montesquieu, the book written by him, The Spirit of the Laws, and he proposed a division of power within the government. And division of power within the government means division of powers between legislature, executive, and the judiciary. So different philosophers provided their ideas to spread awareness among people. Now you just see the symbols. These symbols were also encouraged because we are talking about the 18th century where majority of men and women could not read or write. So images and symbols were frequently used instead of printed words to communicate important ideas. So now we will discuss about the different symbols. The broken chain, that means freedom. Chains were used to fetter slaves. So automatically, broken chain stands for the act of becoming free. Next, the bundle of rods or chains. These all are one more questions which are very important for the examination point of view also. The bundle of rods, that means strength lies in unity. You should just know the exact meaning of that. The eye within a triangle radiating light, that means knowledge. And the rays of the sun will drive away the clouds of ignorance. And that is through knowledge, education. Next, scripture, that is symbol of royal power. Another symbol, snake biting its tail to form a ring. That means eternity. Ring has no beginning or end. Red Ferengin cap. This is a symbol. When a slave becomes free, blue, white, red. That is a national colors of France and the winged woman. That means personification of the law, importance of the laws. So these were the symbols for the illiterate people to unify them. Now France becomes a constitutional monarch. That means king will act according to the constitution as National Assembly completed the draft of the constitution in 1791. And the main purpose was to limit the powers of monarch. And instead of powers concentrated in one hand. Now it is divided among different institutions, as the ideas supported by different philosophers, like legislature, executive, and judicial. And this made France a constitutional monarch. Now, the Constitution of 1791 declared all males were equal before the law. So that means the first important powers granted to men, not all, only men got rights. It limited the power of the monarchy, established the legislative assembly to make laws and collect taxes, and granted all tax-paying male citizens the right to elect members of the legislative assembly. Actually, 1791 Constitution vested the power to make laws in the National Assembly, indirectly elected. Now, citizens were also categorized into two parts, that is, active citizens and passive citizens. Do you know who are called active citizens? Who were called active citizens? Yes, Aaron.
Can I tell?
Yes, better.
Ma'am, active citizens are those, ma'am, who are above 25 age and pays tax, that is at least, ma'am, 3 days of a laborer's wage.
Better, but exactly active citizens means those who got right to vote. Yes, Pratna.
Ma'am, I want to say that active citizens are the one who have right to vote.
Yes, active citizens means that right to vote, but only men. Above 25 years of age, and they were paying taxes to at least 3 days of a laborer's wage, they got the status of active citizens. And they got right to vote. And passive citizens means no voting rights, and that population were about 3 million. So social and economic rights also provided through this constitution, abolished special privileges of the nobility, announced an end to feudalism, and taxes will be levied on ability to pay them. Reforms are changes made to fix and the way our government system operates. National Assembly declared rights of man and the citizens. And the constitution began with it. Rights, like right to life, freedom of speech, freedom of opinion, equality before law, established as natural and inalienable rights. That means they belong to each human being by birth and could not be taken away. And it was a duty of the state to protect each citizen's natural rights. The Constitution of 1791, the new legislative assembly is created to make laws, collect taxes, and decide on issues of war and peace. So these were the rights of men and citizens. Some rights. Now, France becomes a constitutional monarch and abolishes monarchy. But situation in France continued to be tense during the following years. Although Louis XVI signed the constitution, but he entered secret negotiations with Austria and Prussia. Rulers of other neighboring countries too were worried about the development in France, and that's why they were ready to take part, to give help to Louis XVI. And that's why they made plans to send troops to put down the events that had been taking place since 1789. But before that, National Assembly voted in 1792 and declared war against Austria and Prussia. Thousands of volunteers thronged from the provinces to join the army. And this was a war against kings and aristocracies all over Europe. Patriotic songs like Marseillaise, composed by the poet Roget de Isle, sung for the first time by volunteers. And after that, it became the national anthem of France. On 9th of 1792, nearly 30,000 French citizens attacked Prussia and Austria. Louis XVI and his family hiding were arrested, and the king was guillotined. You just see, Louis XVI accused of plotting against the government because he has betrayed against the government of National Convention and against France.